Good afternoon. The first item of business this afternoon is Time for Reflection. And our Time for Reflection leader today is Mike Pilavachi, MBE, Senior Pastor, Soul Survivor, Watford Church.
Good afternoon. Late one evening, a friend of mine was on his way home when he saw a 15-year-old boy sitting on a fence, sobbing. They began to chat, and the boy shared his story. He had never known his dad. His mum had died 2 years earlier, and both his older brothers were in prison. He was being looked after by a social worker who, in his words, didn't want to know. And his girlfriend had just broken up with him. This boy kept repeating through his tears to a complete stranger, "I just want to know that someone loves me. I just want to know that someone loves me." His cry, the desire to be loved, is rooted inside the heart of every person. It might just be that some of us are better at hiding it than he was. Some time ago, the mayor of Watford visited our church, and we asked him what, in his opinion, was the greatest problem Watford faced. His response: the number one problem is loneliness. The number two problem is car parking. I am here to tell you, car parking in Watford is a very big problem. Sometimes we need to remind ourselves why we continue to wrestle through the challenge of elected politics. It's because there are people in our nation who are hurting. There are people in our nation who are broken. There are people who are dying, literally sometimes, of loneliness. There have never been more of us living on this island we call home, and yet, in a way, we have never lived further apart. We need to recognize that loneliness is as much a social ill that needs fixing as is inflation and the price of petrol. How might we fix this? We cannot outlaw loneliness. No legislation can wrap an arm around that young boy's shoulder and comfort him. But the leaders of a country set a tone through their behaviour. We can start by modelling love, by remembering the words of Mother Teresa, who said, "Three things in human life are important. The first is to be kind. The second is to be kind. The third is to be kind." We can follow the footsteps of Jesus Christ, who demonstrated in life and death what it was to love friend and enemy alike. Publicly and privately, we can be gracious, listen well, and disagree agreeably. In this way, perhaps, we begin to give a lead in addressing that deep need of the people we are here to serve. I just want to know that someone loves me. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Pilavachi.